Hey, thanks for being here. Are you a Christian? If so, have you ever heard of the concept of mixing law and grace? If this sounds like maybe a foreign subject to you, I encourage you to stick around. This video is a summary of Acts chapter 15. It's designed to support my Bible reading challenge, which is currently reading Acts through Philemon, one chapter a day, 5 days a week, and all of my content supports each of those chapters. So, this is Acts chapter 15, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to read the very first verse, and I think you'll see very quickly the concept of mixing law and grace and what the problem with that can be. So let's read Acts 15, verse 1. And certain men which came down from Judea, okay, so these are Jews, taught the brethren and said, and this is a pivotal statement that they made, except ye be circumcised after the manner of Moses, ye cannot be saved. I want you to hang on to that phrase, ye cannot be saved. It's a definitive statement. So if you're watching this without the notes on the screen, such as on TikTok or somewhere else, I encourage you to go to my YouTube channel and you can see all of my notes on the screen. Of course, all my notes are in the comment of this post. Either way, so I'm going to break down Acts 15:1 in a slightly different way. Okay. And it's not to add words to God's words or anything like that. I just want to expand on this thought of, except you be circumcised after the manner of Moses, you cannot be saved. And although in my life, nobody's ever told me, hey, you got to be circumcised if you're going to be saved. The rest of the things that I'm going to list here, I have heard personally on multiple occasions. Okay. So this is a very real thing within Christendom. And just within religion, so it's a huge problem. And I want you to stick around so you can see how Paul and Barnabas and the other disciples and apostles dealt with this critical issue. All right, so bear with me as I read and read a slightly modified Acts 15:1. And certain men which came down from your city taught the Christians and said, except ye be circumcised after the manner of Moses, or water baptized after the manner of John, or speak in tongues after the manner of Acts 2, or go to church on Saturday after the manner of Seventh Day Adventists, or confess your sins on a daily basis, or avoid blaspheming the Holy Spirit, or keep the law of Moses, or tithe, ye cannot be saved. Okay, I assure you, I've heard all of those things except the circumcision one, multiple times throughout my life. So let's look at how did Paul and Barnabas resolve this heated issue presented by those wanting to mix law and grace. Acts 15:23. We're going to read some Bible here today. So I hope that's okay with you. We're going to start in verse 23. And they, okay, so they is, being led by Paul and Barnabas and all the apostles and some of the disciples. And they wrote letters by them after this manner. The apostles and elders and brethren send greeting unto the brethren which are of the Gentiles in Antioch and Syria and Cilicia. Okay, this is critical because this is primarily, if not solely, Jews writing and addressing the Gentiles. Okay, so the question isn't, okay, so pretty much for the most part, without I'm sure there was exceptions, but every Jew was circumcised. That was kind of like, a rite of Judaism, so to speak. But Gentiles were not circumcised. And so this is Jews who don't believe you should mix law and grace addressing Gentiles on this issue. Okay, so I just want to kind of frame that all for you. And so what they're doing is they're providing written communication on this topic. Verse 24, for as much as we have heard that certain which went out from us have troubled you with words. Now listen to this next thing, subverting your souls. Hey, I often say words matter, and I believe that wholeheartedly. And verses like this tell me how powerful words can be, because for some reason, God allowed this idea that words could subvert your soul. Okay, now how would that happen? Look, the only thing that can send you to hell is by you not trusting in the Lord Jesus Christ. But words can prevent an individual from trusting in the Lord Jesus Christ. or adding works to that trust. And now it's no longer grace, but it's works and grace. Okay, and that's a huge problem. Much of Paul's writings address this issue from multiple different angles. Okay. Subverting your souls, saying ye must be circumcised and keep the law, to whom we gave no such commandment. Okay, so Paul and Barnabas are saying, we gave no such commandment to this thing. Verse 25, it seemed good unto us, being assembled with one accord, to send chosen men unto you with our beloved Barnabas and Paul, men that have hazarded their lives for the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Okay, so they're credentialing these men, so to speak. We have sent therefore Judas and Silas, who shall also tell you the same things by mouth. Okay, so they are providing written instruction and verbal instruction so that there's no miscommunication on this important topic. Verse 28, for it seemed good to the Holy Ghost and to us to lay upon you no greater burden than these necessary things. So what are these necessary things? Acts 15, 29, it says that ye abstain from meats offered to idols and from blood and from things strangled and from fornication. Well, look, this is all great information, right? You shouldn't eat blood today. So what Satanists do? That's what people that are completely ignorant do. From which, if ye keep yourselves, now listen, ye shall do well. Fare ye well. Okay, remember now, the certain men from Judea were Jews trying to burden people with works-based salvation by teaching that circumcision was required. And they said, you have to be circumcised to be saved. So this consolation of abstaining from meats offered to idols and from blood and from things that are strangled and from fornication, they're saying, if you do those things, you'll do well, not you will be saved. See the difference? All right. It's a huge difference. And it's one that a lot of Christian individuals struggle with. You know, they think, oh, well, I have to tithe. And in their mind, they're thinking, that's how I maintain my salvation. Or I have to confess my sins because that's how I maintain my salvation. And people are in maintenance mode of their salvation. And I'm telling you, friend, that is not, you could not do anything to earn your salvation. You can't do anything to keep your salvation. That's completely 100% in the hands of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, what you can do is you can do good works that honor your walk and your life as a Christian, but it has nothing to do with your salvation. Okay. All right. Point number two, we're moving on in our summary, and I'm almost done. Two short points. Look at Paul's enthusiasm for other Christians. I want to read this verse. Acts 15, 36 says, and some days after, Paul said unto Barnabas, let us go again and visit our brethren in every city where we have preached the word of the Lord and see how they do. Hey, I almost wish there was an exclamation point at the end of that, because when I read it, I think that Paul must have just been like chomping at the bit. Hey, Barnabas, let's go see how the brethren are doing. You know, that's kind of the feel that it has. All right. And I encourage all of the people that follow me and that are listening to my content, when you read God's words, don't just read it like it's black and white text on a page. Imagine yourself in that situation. I mean, can you imagine if Paul would have walked up to Barnabas and been like, hey, Barnabas, I don't know. What do you think? Should we go see how the brethren are doing? I don't know. What do you think? Yeah, I guess so. Let's go. Can you imagine if that was Paul? Ugh, it's terrible. But when you read all of Paul's books, you know he probably said it like, hey, Barnabas, let us go down and visit our brethren, you know, and go to every city where we preach the word of the Lord. Let's see how they do. You know, this is how I imagine Paul being. Okay, so I'm done imagining. Third point to conclude this summary of Acts chapter 15. Verses 37 through 41, it concludes the chapter with Paul and Barnabas splitting up due to the contention over a disciple who was mentioned in the chapter. It's John, his surname is Mark. And on a previous trip, this specific individual kind of left them in the middle of the trip, didn't go do the work. And so Paul didn't want to take him with him again. But Barnabas saw something else. And so Paul and Barnabas split ways. And honestly, it was probably the will of God to separate these two key men so that more ground could be covered. But that's kind of my assumption. So, hey, I appreciate you being here. And I hope that you got some encouragement from it.
Hey, thanks for being here. Are you a Christian? If so, have you ever